Hello and welcome to Big Picture. I am Vishal Dahiya, and today we will talk about the freebie model of governance. Now, the role of freebies in Indian politics has been expanding, especially in the past decade or so. Political parties have changed their strategy for attracting the voters. Now, freebies cover a wide range of goods and services such as bicycles, laptops, smartphones, TV sets, waiver on water and electricity bills, etc. An analysis of manifestos of various political parties done by Election Commission earlier this year revealed a marked emphasis on distribution of freebies and doles to voters. Almost all political parties promise freebies, which are then implemented in some way or the other once they are voted to power. So what is the rationale behind this freebie model of governance, and how sustainable or justified is this model? For more on this, we're joined by a distinguished panel of guests today. Let me start by introducing them to you, beginning with Ms. Aditi Fadnis, political editor of Business Standard. We also have with us senior journalist Mr. Ashok Tandon. And we are also joined by Mr. Sanjay Kumar, the director of Center for Study of Developing Societies there as well. Welcome all of you to Rajya Sabha TV studios. Let me begin with you, Mr. Tandon. And let's try and understand this particular model. When we say the freebies model of governance, something which you, having been a journalist, if you look at the development of this particular, practice, it is not very old. If we look at it that way, it's not very new as well, and it has been practiced by almost all political parties.
No, one thing is your pre-election promises. The other is before the election is announced, the party in power announces something. Mm-hmm. And the other is that the parties in opposition announcing something as a manifesto. So it has been growing in Indian politics, and if I am not wrong, Tamil Nadu enjoys that distinction of introducing the freebies in Indian politics.
And takes the lead as well.
Yes, and their freebies were challenged in the court also, Supreme Court. And Supreme Court had given certain guidelines and even asked the Election Commission to revise the Code of Conduct and also laid down certain guidelines. And a lot of things have been done to check it, but unfortunately, all political parties have been, indulging in it in some way or the other. For instance, if the party is in power, let's take the case of Delhi, very recent announcements made by the incumbent Chief Minister Kejriwal, mm-hmm. About power, free power, free water and free bus pass for women. So these are the freebies being announced by the party in power prior to the announcement of the election, almost 6 months before the election. So will it also come under corrupt practices, as the Supreme Court said? Mm-hmm. Perhaps no, because now he is doing, and the opposition is criticizing it. But when it comes to making promises, you never know what the opposition will make promise. Mm-hmm. So I think it's not good, it's not very healthy. And it actually comes from the taxpayers' money. And people do talk that, well, from my pocket you are taking out money and giving it free tickets or pass to women. So it is not appreciated by the people. Nobody likes it, but still it is being done in the hope that it will influence the voter. But okay. I think since it has influenced the voters, particularly in a state like Tamil Nadu, then we saw in recent election similar things were promised in Telangana, also in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, name any state. More of it is coming from the state governments for the state election. So therefore, it's not very healthy practice, and it corrupts the political system also. But I have a feeling that we underestimate the judgment of the electorate in this country, mm-hmm. because the last Lok Sabha election, the way people gave a massive mandate to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, it was certainly not based on any freebies or any promise of freebie for that matter. So if people are wise enough, people are very intelligent, they are educated, they know how to vote in favor of a particular, then why political parties are still vying for it. That's a big question which all political parties will have to ponder over it. It's not for you and me to discuss and give any kind of a judgment. Mm-hmm. But it is for the larger interest of parliamentary democracy in this country. And Supreme Court has also made very strong observations, mm-hmm, that it is not a healthy democracy or it's not a healthy practice.
Okay.
But still, unfortunately, I think it's largely will have to be left to the political parties.
Okay, largely.
To some extent, to the election commission to evolve a code of conduct. But ultimately, you know, it's the parliamentary democracy rests on the strength of the political party.
Okay.
So it is for them to decide whether to continue with this practice and also in the ultimate analysis, give a bad name to Indian democracy.
Okay, let me bring in Aditi here. Aditi, what do you make of this, you know, the freebie model and the way Mr. Tandon has pointed out that ultimately the responsibility lies with the political parties as well, before the elections when they are putting in their manifestos and if they are in power as well, right before the elections or maybe throughout that 5 years of governance, instead of going for the freebie model, they could adopt some other model then?
Well, there are two aspects of it. One is whether, you know, what kind of freebies are given.
Mm-hmm.
And two, whether they work. So, in states where the overall state structure has succeeded in passing on the fruit of development to people, I think freebies don't really work. But at the same time, we've seen, in as Tandon Saab said, in the case of Tamil Nadu, the overall state structure of governance is pretty good relative to the rest of India.
Mm-hmm.
But yet people feel compelled to give freebies. And so when this matter was flagged with former Chief Minister Jayalalitha in a moment of rare communication to her bureaucrats, she told them that every election we are out of ideas. We don't know what to give to people overall, over and above what we've already done for them.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have a politics of plenty, you have your voters have water, they have electricity, they have roads, they have subsidized transport, they have subsidized food. They what do you give them then?
But what
election?
Do you make of promises like the ones which have been recently made, as Mr. Tandon was also pointing out, from the state government in Delhi about, you know, waiver on electricity bills, waiver on water bills, free rides to a particular section of the society, a particular gender, and so on and so forth?
So all said and done, if your governance has been good overall, which as Nitish Kumar, as Chief Minister, he was once asked, and his comment was that you can rest assured that you have provided good governance if three institutions of the state work properly. One is the daroga, the SHO.
Mm-hmm.
The other is the person who handles your trains, the TT.
Mm-hmm.
And the third is, and now another one that has been added, is the bank babu, the person in the bank. So if these three things are, these three things kind of govern an individual's existence, and if these three things work, then you have no need for freebies.
Okay.
So I think in the case of Delhi, a lot has been done, but perhaps it is felt by the Delhi government that not enough has been done.
Maybe it is part of the political thought process and their political system, their particular party's system as well. But let's also bring in Mr. Sanjay Kumar here from CSTS. Sanjay, if you look at, you know, this culture of freebies, and as both Mr. Tandon and Ms. Aditi has also pointed out, that it can be broadly divided into two categories. One, where political parties are making promises in their manifestos before the elections, and two, the parties which are in power in particular states, you know, go ahead and bring in these schemes, like the recent ones of a waiver on electricity bill or a water bill or a bus ride or a metro ride, and then try and project them in the forthcoming elections as their achievement. So how do you know, look at these particular this particular way of doing politics?
So first we have to make a distinction between what is a freebie and what is a poll promise.
Mm-hmm.
What has been announced by the government, freebie can be only the policy of freebie can be adopted only if by the government in power, the party in power. policies, promises could be made by any political party.
Mm-hmm.
So what Delhi government has done is to indulge into freebies. So you are in power, you are offering people free things. So you are offering people free electricity, free water in the case of Delhi, and maybe free ride to the DTC bus.
Mm-hmm.
Poll promises are something different and freebies are different. We have to make that distinction.
But Sanjay, poll promises made by the poll promises made by political parties in their manifestos before the election, then these political parties are duty bound to go and implement those promises. So they also, if those parties are elected, are voted to power, then they will also implement those promises,
so
and those promises
demand.
Will become
that's
freebies.
The demand at the moment. No, that is the criticism, that a political party, there is an election, political party comes up with a manifesto and they make an announcement, they are going to do certain things, they are going to give free, etc., etc. But there is no legality to these promises. There is no legality how these political parties could be actually made responsible if they don't deliver.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a debate which is going on, that election commission should make it mandatory for political parties that once you make an announcement in your manifesto, you are legally bound to at least explain to the people at the time of election, next election, why you have not been able to fulfill.
Mm-hmm.
So let's make the distinction, and there is a clear distinction. We don't have to do that.
Okay.
Freebies are different and poll promises are different. Freebies are when you are in power, you dole out things, you actually give out free things to your voters. Yes, in the hope that these things are going to help you in the next election, and what is happening in Delhi is an example of that.
Mm-hmm.
Elections are due in February 2020, and I think Aam Aadmi Party may not be very sure, in spite of their decent governance in terms of education or health, there could be differences on that, but they are not very sure whether those good governance in terms of two sectors can help them win elections. So what mm-hmm. they are trying to do is to make an extra effort to win sections of voters which could help them win the election which is due next year.
Okay.
So parties engage, government engage in freebies. I think if the government has performed well, and Aditi did mention about Nitish Kumar, if you have done well throughout last 5 years, government can expect, government may decide that we don't want to indulge in freebies.
Okay.
And we will go with our record of governance to the people. If the people are happy with our governance, they will vote for us.
Okay.
But since government has not been able to fulfill the desire of the people, fulfill the need of the people, and that is why this whole culture of freebies has come up in the last 10 years.
Okay.
And we had a discussion about how it has come up from Tamil Nadu.
Yeah.
And now it has traveled to the north as well, up till Delhi now.
Okay. Sanjay, one more question, and I add on one out there. Then how do you look at, how would you see the sustainability of this model of governance there?
No, this is not sustainable. I'm not arguing that this is a good model, this is sustainable, this is economically viable. This is absolutely a bad model of governance. If a government indulges into freebies, which is an indication that your 5 years of governance or your 4 years of governance, if you start, doling out freebies mm-hmm. at the last minute, indicate that you're not sure of your governance. You're
okay.
not sure whether people are happy about what you have been able to do for the people of your state or your country
okay.
for the last 4.5 years or 4 years. So when the government is unsure of people being happy, people being satisfied about their performance,
okay.
then only these parties and government, dole out these freebies.
Okay.
So it's not at all a good model. This is a very bad model of governance.
Okay, not sustainable, and something which is part of, those parties which are in power, part of their strategy to go ahead and face the next election. But when very important point, Mr. Tandon, which was made by Sanjay in his first remark, and I'd like to bring you on that is, is there a way out, of ensuring that this does not spread further by ensuring a legality of the manifestos of political parties?
Certainly, if you look at the Subramanyam Balaji case in Tamil Nadu, although Supreme Court made very strong strictures against this culture, but it had to uphold the petition because the promises were made in the Election Commission. But at the same time, Supreme Court directed the Election Commission to ensure that in the Code of Conduct, Model Code of Conduct, there are guidelines that the political parties will not make such promises in the election manifesto. Mm-hmm. Because having made that promise in election manifesto, you have to comply with that. So therefore, now if you look at the new model code of conduct, there is a very clear guideline that the political parties will not make such announcements as part of their election manifesto. So therefore, the election commission also has limitations in containing such things as far as the election is concerned. But the larger responsibility lies on the political parties. But I think even if the political parties are in this mad race, the people of India on a large number of occasions have proved them wrong, that your freebies or your announcements will not work. Mm-hmm. Like if I give you an example, in the last Chhattisgarh election, the Congress won because people thought the perception was because of the loan waiver. But the same Chhattisgarh people in the Lok Sabha election voted very heavily in favor of Narendra Modi for the center. So it was not necessary that it was the loan waiver which helped Congress win. Could be it is the anti-incumbency of the Raman Singh government which helped it. Mm-hmm. So therefore, I think the political parties will have to make an analysis from election to election whether these things have worked. For instance, all of us are now talking in terms of the forthcoming Delhi election. Mm-hmm. You know, 300 crore per year will be lost if the DTC is made free for women. You can imagine the amount of money it's going from the taxpayer. Mm-hmm. It makes people irresponsible that the people who can afford a bus ticket are now being given free ride just because they happen to be women. Similarly, you know, it doesn't help the poor also. And therefore, I think it's a very bad policy. But largely, people will have to come up, rise to the occasion and give a befitting reply to such things. Even if they accept it, they need not vote for it.
Okay.
And I think the biggest example has been the last Lok Sabha election, in which the elections were fought on a national security issue, on other political issues, and people voted for Modi. And even the announcements of the NDA that 6,000 rupees per annum will be given to farmer, and then Rahul Gandhi announced 60,000 for the same thing, but mm-hmm. people did not go for the 60,000 dole out, and they voted still in favor of a party which could provide strong leadership, which could think in terms of national security and a stable government. Mm-hmm. I think largely people want a stable government at the center, a responsible government at the center, a strong leadership at the center. So they don't go for freebies. Then why only in states such thing appear to be working, at least in the context of the political parties. Mm-hmm. And that is why this thing is not ending.
Okay.
So I think even at this panchayat level or municipal level or even at the state assembly level, if people start rejecting those political parties who offer or try to, you know, influence them through freebies rather than a very constructive program.
Okay.
So therefore, firstly, the election commission, the courts, then finally the political parties, and ultimately the people.
The onus lies with the voter only. Ultimately. Aditi, do you agree with that aspect? And also, you know, one more addition is that maybe, you know, these policies which are adopted by the elected governments of, you know, announcing freebies, if they could be more specific, as Mr. Tandon was pointing out, instead of to an entire section, maybe those who need it, for the needy people, if some policies can be specifically made for them.
So there is a difference certainly between a subsidy and a freebie, and I totally agree with Tandon Saab that women don't, I mean, it really doesn't matter if bus rides for women are free. It doesn't really influence the way they vote. Their priorities are somewhat different. So you need security, you need safety, you need, and let's also understand that money is finite, money is not infinite. So if you subsidize or if you excuse women from paying for a bus ride, then you will have to make sure that the money that you are writing off will have to come from somewhere else by cutting something else.
Mm-hmm.
And that is not necessarily a good idea.
Okay.
So I don't think this is such a smart move. If you've done your work, if you've done development, if people feel that this is a government that is looking out for us, that will take care of us, then they don't require freebies at all.
But then looking at the scenarios like the state of Tamil Nadu, are these exceptions? Because they are in both the political players, the major political players have been indulging in these sort of exercises.
Vishal, I can count you election after election where freebies have been doled out competitively, and yet one party has won the election and one party has lost it. So if there is a competition for freebies, then why both parties should win theoretically,
okay,
which is not possible in a democracy.
So what you are also saying is that it does not impact the voters' mindset when it comes to going ahead.
If you have done your work, if you are providing good governance, if you have your finger on the people's pulse and you understand what people want, right, wrong, I'm not arguing on that. I think national security is important, but food is important also, jobs are important also, and we are seeing a crisis on those fronts mm-hmm. at this point. That's a different matter, that's a different debate. But I think if you do if you do governance properly, and if you know what it is that people really want,
mm-hmm.
And why you are elected with a certain purpose, then
those might not have to resort to these exercises to go ahead and dole out those freebies. Let me bring in Sanjay again out there. Sanjay, as you were suggesting earlier in your first response, similar responses coming in from Mr. Tandon and Aditi out here as well. But according to you, what might be the way out here onwards? Does the onus only lies on the political parties who are in power, those who are governing these states, or it also lies on the voter?
See, the onus, all these, the actors which you mentioned are all actors in politics. When election take place, all these are actors. So the onus lies on everyone, I believe. We cannot fix the onus that, only political parties have the responsibility to control freebies, or only the people have to the responsibility to control freebies.
Mm-hmm.
But my own sense is that at the moment, if you look at the rules and regulations, there is no way you can control freebies legally, because these are government's announcements by the government. If a part, as I mentioned earlier also, we have to make a distinction. Let's not mix up. Freebies and poll promises are different. So freebies, a party is in power. Yes, people can question. Opposition can question that you are, promising. You have already made announcement that you will give free electricity and free water and XYZ.
Mm-hmm.
Where is this money coming from? But there is no way legally you can control the government. You can say the government that you are not able to do that. You can go to the court. Court can pass strictures. Everybody has a responsibility, and rightly pointed out, if we look at Tamil Nadu, both the political parties dole out freebies, but one political party win and one political party lose. There is no guarantee that if a political party gives freebies that the political party will win election. It only helps a little bit if you are on the edge, if party okay. thinks that they are very little uncertain.
Mm-hmm.
So it helps in motivating, mobilizing tiny percentages of voter, but as you know, in competitive elections, even 1-2% votes makes a difference.
Okay.
So the responsibility, your basic question, whose responsibility is it to, if not finish freebies, but at least to eliminate?
Mm-hmm.
I think finally, if voters make a decision, somebody has come to me and if I say, I'm not going to accept anything, I think then parties would have no option but to, don't come to the voters. They will have to sit back and say, okay, we have to campaign. We have to make promises to the people on positive things. Freebies are not working because people have started rejecting freebies.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mr. Tandon, can I comment from you on this?
See, I think it undermines the judgment of the people. It also tends to undermine our election process, and also undermines or rather threatens the parliamentary democracy in this country. Because if you look at the democracies all over the world, the elections are fought on the basis of the performance of your government or the lack of it by the opposition, rather than promising freebies.
Okay.
So if we continue like that, I know it's very difficult, it's an unending process, it is getting more and more traction over the years, but I have a feeling that we are not strengthening our democratic fabric by allowing such things. But ultimately, it is for the people to reject those things, and the political parties also to analyze, like in Tamil Nadu, if in spite of all that, the anti-incumbency against the IADM government worked and DMK has won, so it was not on the basis of either side giving freebies.
Okay.
So ultimately, India is a vibrant democracy. The whole world, in fact, the developing countries look toward India as a model, role model of democracy, and what kind of democracy we are developing. So ultimately, I think it's a very serious issue on which the all political party needs to ponder over.
Okay. Aditi, do you agree? Both political parties and the voters have the onus here.
Yes, indeed. And I think this is a, I know it sounds, barely sounds believable, but I think this is a passing phase. And as governments are come under increasing pressure to perform by way of governance, this will recede. And other things which are more important will take their place.
Okay, so there it is, as our panelists are also pointing out, that as far as the freebie model of governance is concerned, it definitely doesn't look like very sustainable and not exactly the election winning formula every time. But to go ahead and do away with such a sort of culture, the onus, as our panelists were pointing out, also lies on both sides. That is, the political parties who are contesting elections, making promises before the election and policies after the election to make those promises and policies more informed ones, and the voters as well, by asking informed questions. We'll come back again tomorrow with a different topic and different set of guests. Till then, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.